For education and sports, First Lady Janet Museveni has reaffirmed government's commitment to reopen schools at the beginning of next year. She also called for support in the reconstruction of legacy schools. She was speaking at Gaza High School in Wakiso District at the commissioning of the students' hostel that has been refurbished after it was burnt down last year. Our reporter was there.
While commissioning the students' dormitory at Gayaza High School today, the Minister for Education and Sports, Janet Museveni, assured parents that schools will reopen without fail in January. She, however, asked them to be patient with the government.
As the president announced, the tertiary institutions will open at the beginning of November and the rest of our learners in January next year. And I trust that God will bless that program and it will happen as we have said.
The Kobe House Hostel, which was today opened by the First Lady, was gutted by fire last year in March. Students' belongings worth millions were burnt to ashes, although no life was lost. The Education Ministry contributed over 898 million shillings towards the restoration of the hostel.
I received your request for support towards the construction of a boundary wall to ensure the safety of the children. The Minister of Finance was directed by the President to raise some 2.2 billion that you requested for. And I know that sometimes the government support takes so long. It has taken long, but it never fails to come. So be sure that that money will come, and by the grace of God, that too will be done.
The reconstruction work was done by ABBA Company. Engineer Patrick Sewanyana used the moment to ask the First Lady to give local construction companies priority when it comes to construction contracts. The Minister of State for Higher Education, Dr. John Chrysostom Muyingo, commended the school management for transparency and accountability after they reported residual balance of 81 million shillings from the project.
I want to commend the management for following our guidelines in procuring and carrying out the renovation of the dormitory in the agreed time. And also, Mama, I want to thank them for making a saving. This has not happened anywhere in this country, at least in the recent past. Making a saving of 81 million Uganda shillings that was used to renovate other structures. These structures, when I visited, were not like that, Mama. But the amount of money we gave them, they were able to build even a bigger dormitory and it made a saving. You don't hear this in Uganda these days, Mama. I want to thank the management.
Gayaza High School, which was established in 1905, is a Church of Uganda girls' school under Namirembe Diocese. Reverend Nathan Mulondo represented the diocese at the event and lauded the government for the landmark achievement.
We appreciate God for the help that we have seen coming from government and from the ministry that has used you to put this back to place. We continue to give the glory back to the Lord. And again, I want to appreciate you and your ministry. There are many voices that have been coming to your office and the rest up to the down office requesting you to open schools. We want to thank you so much for your guidance. We truly believe it is the wise counsel. We give glory to God. Our students and pupils are safe when they are at home. I do believe with your counsel and your team, at the time come, they will get back to school. We shall have a better Uganda. We appreciate that.
Report by Robin Anantale for the news.